The main players of this drama played a pivotal role in the shaping of the history of the 19th century. Queen Victoria, for instance, Lord Dalhousie, who was Governor General of India for a period of time and was probably one of the most hated Governor Generals of India, even today. And then you have Maharaja Dalip Singh himself and Princess Victoria Gowramma. She is somewhat more of a shadowy figure than Dalip Singh, who was, of course, Maharaja of the Punjab. And then you have his mother, the Maharani Jindal, who was described as the Messalina of India. And then you also have Princess Victoria Gowramma's own father, the ex-Maharaja, or the ex-rascally Raja, as Lord Dalhousie described him, of Coorg. Queen Victoria played the unlikely and, in the end, unsuccessful role of Cupid in this story, because these were the first two, and I dare say the last two royals, who were converted to Christianity. And Queen Victoria thought that this would be a fantastic starting point for creating a Christian nation. That is Princess Victoria Gowramma of Coorg. The father decided Gowramma, his favorite daughter, should convert to Christianity. And he could then say to the East India Company that because she wanted to convert to Christianity, he wanted her to get a good Western education. And strangely enough, they fell for it. In the meanwhile, let's go back to Dalip Singh. He was converted to Christianity in Fatehgarh. Gowramma was a bit too flirtatious for him to marry, so he didn't marry her. He married Princess Bamba Mula. He was probably the first Indian nationalist because he had the vision of uniting the princely and the non-princely states, Sikhs, Muslims, Hindus and Christians. We do have to give him that credit. That the lives of Dalip Singh and Victoria Gowramma are indeed allegories for the 19th century. So thank you very much.